Okay, today we see the example number, exercise number 4 or 5, I don't see. Exercise number 4, Mr. A keeps his books under single entry system. He keeps his books under single entry system. During the year ended 31st 1984, his cash transactions were as under. He has given the cash transactions made during the year, receipts on the receipt side and payments on the payment side. Okay, receipt side, you see there the first item, the first item, cash, fresh capital brought in cash. Fresh capital brought in cash is the additional capital. This is the additional capital you have to take in the balance sheet. You add to the opening capital, 15,000. Second, private dividend paid into bank. Private dividend paid into bank means it is the his private income. Private income paid into the business bank account means it is cash introduced in the business. Cash introduced in the business is nothing but it is also additional capital. Remember this. Okay. Private money introduced in the business is called as capital. Okay. Business money utilized for private purpose is called as drawing. Remember these two points. Once again, I'll repeat. Private money invested in the business is called as additional capital, and business money used for private purpose is called drawing. Okay, these two are to be added in the capital, additional capital, as additional capital. Additional capital is 15,200. Then collection from the debtors. You take this item in the debtors account credit side by cash. Debtors account credit side by cash. Then cash sale is here. You take this cash sale to trading account credit side. Cash sale. Okay. Then come to the payment side. Paid to creditors. This goes to creditors account debit side to cash. Wages. This goes to trading account debit side to wages. Salary goes to P&L account debit side to salary. Next is rent. Rent goes to P&L account debit side to rent. Okay. You see here, purchase of cycle for his son. Okay. Purchase of cycle for his son. Okay. Son is his relative. His son, it means it is the not a business transaction. It is not a business transaction. It is a personal transaction. For personal purpose, he purchased the cycle. So that cycle amount is to be called as drawing. Okay. Money used. Purchase means he paid cash. He paid cash for purchase of cycle for his son. That means business cash used for private purpose or personal purpose. Therefore, it is called as drawing. This amount is called as drawing. And another drawing is there, 3,000. Okay, these two drawings, 3,000 plus 300. 3,300 drawing is to be deducted in the capital adjustment in the balance sheet. In the balance sheet, capital, you deduct these two. That means totally 3,300. Remember this point. Okay. This is regarding the cash flow. And the you see this statement, is it a cash book or it is a statement containing receipts and payments? Okay. I have a doubt regarding, is it a cash book or it is a statement only? Okay. If it is a cash book, it starts with opening balance. and ends with closing balance. Opening balance and closing balance are not given in this statement. So it is not a cash book. It is only statement. You have to rewrite. You have to rewrite this as cash book once again. Starting with the opening balance and ending with the closing balance. Remember this. If this statement starts with opening balance and ends with closing balance, this is called as cash book, then there is no need of preparing the cash book again. Therefore, here opening balance and closing balance are not given. Therefore, you consider this is a statement only, not an account. So you have to prepare once again cash book. Okay, come to the next part. Assets and liabilities were as follows. Okay, particular 1/1/1984. 1/1/1984 means opening. 31/12/1984 means closing. Opening and closing balances are given. Then all the opening balance you take in the opening statement of affairs. Opening statement of affairs. And all the opening balances must go for the account as a opening balance. If you opened the account relating to these, you have to take in the opening, take as a opening balance in the account. Remember this point. Opening balances are to be taken in the two places. One is in statement of affairs, another in the account as opening balance if there is a account. If there is a account. Okay. And the closing balance is to be taken in the balance sheet. And that is to be taken in the account as closing balance if there is an account. Remember these two points. These are the clues you have to remember. Okay, come to the first. Sundry debtors, opening goes to opening statement of affairs and closing goes to balance sheet, and you have to take in the account. To balance brought down, by balance carried down. In the same way, creditors, opening in the opening statement of affairs, closing in the closing balance sheet. Then opening comes to by balance brought down in the creditor's account, to balance carried down closing account, closing balance. Okay. Stock, opening stock, opening statement of affairs, opening statement of affairs, closing stock, balance sheet, and these two must enter in the trading account. Four times. Land and building. Opening statement of affairs, closing statement of affairs. Sorry, closing balance sheet. Furniture, opening statement of affairs, closing balance sheet. Cash in hand. Opening is to be recorded. Cash in hand, 800. Cash at bank, opening in the opening statement of affairs you take, and opening balance you take in the cash book. You have to take in the cash book. So these two balance you have to take to the opening balance in this cash book. In this cash book, you have to take these two balance as opening. And whatever closing is here, this goes to closing balance sheet. You have to take in the closing balance sheet. And these two must take in the cash book debit side here as closing balance, by balance carried down. Remember this. Okay. This is the point you remember. Then next come to depreciate land and building by 5%. 5% depreciation on building. Building is 4,000. 5% of that is 200. 200 depreciation on building you take in the P&L account and deduct in the balance sheet. And next is furniture, 10% you take in the P&L account, depreciation, and deduct in the balance sheet. And provision for doubtful debt, this is to be taken in the P&L account, not in the traders account. Some of my students takes this RDD in the debtors account. It is not a debtors account item, it is a P&L account item. RDD always comes to P&L account, not to the debtors account. Remember this. Once again, I'm repeating. RDD, doubtful debt, you take in the P&L account debit side and deduct in the closing balance of debtors, balance sheet. Clear? This is the point. And next, from the following in from the above in particulars, prepare trading profit and loss account for the year ending 31st of 1984 and the balance sheet as on that date. Okay, they are asked to prepare the balance sheet as on that date. You see the in my printout. I am having the printout. With this printout, I solve the problem. Okay. So you have to keep the printout aside, you people, while attending the lecture. While attending lecture, you keep the printout with you and see the problem. Please mute your audio. Someone is talking. Please mute your audio.
Ah,
Okay, now you see the problem. This is the opening statement of affairs. Okay. First, I will prepare the opening statement of affairs on the basis of opening balances given in the problem. Assets and liability balances in the second part. You take from there. This is the statement of affairs. First item is debtors. Opening debtors is 1,400. Second, creditors item, liability side. Creditors liability side ₹2,730 creditors. Third item stock 2000. Then fourth item land and building 4000. Next furniture 1000. Cash at bank 800. Cash in hand 30. Okay, these are the items in the statement of affairs. Okay, opening balances of accounts are recorded. This is the first opening statement of affairs completed. Opening statement of part completed. Okay, these are the opening balances given in the problem. Next, I'll go to second slide, cash book. I'll prepare the cash book. Okay, this is my cash book. Receipt and payments are given, no doubt. But you have to check it. You have to check that and ascertain the balances or missing information. First, you write the opening balance. Two balance brought down. In your receipt and payment, opening balance is not given. First, you take the opening balance. So opening balance from the opening statement of affairs already prepared or from the account balance. In that, bank balance is 800, cash balance is 30. These two you take opening balance. Total 830 is the balance. It is the hybrid system of cash book. Remember, my dear friends, it is the hybrid system or mixed system. In the cash book itself, I am recording the cash as well as bank transactions. It is allowed. Cash and bank balance. Only single column. With the single column, I am preparing this. Because there is no bifurcated amounts. There is no bifurcated amounts related to bank and cash. Therefore, I am entering the cash and bank transactions in the cash book itself in a single column. First, bank and balance and cash balance is taken. Then you record the items recorded in the receipt side. Receipt side items. First is fresh capital brought in cash. Fresh capital is called as to capital. It is additional capital. It is additional capital. You may write as additional capital or simply write capital account. 15,000 is additional capital. Second is private dividend paid into bank. Private dividend paid into bank is also additional capital. So again, I'll write to capital, 200. Okay, I modified the name. Then cash collection from debtors is there, to debtors account. It is recorded as to debtors 22,000. The next cash sale is there. You record cash sale. Cash sale is 1,200. Debit side completed. Okay, now you go to credit side. Credit side first item is paid to creditors. Paid to creditors means by creditor. Amount 28,200. Next is by wages 1,500. Okay, this is the copy in my hand. Looking at the problem, I'm recording. In this way, you have to record. By wages, then by salary. By salary, 800. By rent. By rent is 1,200. Then purchase of cycle for son. Purchase of cycle for son is drawing. It is a personal expense. So equal as by drawing. By drawing rupees 300. Okay. Next, another drawing is there. Again, you write by drawing. 3,000. Okay, these are the items given in the payment side. Payment side. Then you have to write the closing balance. Okay, because of net problem, I failed to connect. See there, drawing is clear. There are two drawings. Then you have to write the closing balance here. You take the closing balance given in the account balances. Asset and liability balance, there is a closing balance of cash, closing balance of bank. You write it. By balance carried down. Bank is 3,400. Bank is 3,400. Cash is 830. Total of this is 4,230. Okay. This is the cash book. And whatever given in the problem is only a statement. Receipt and payment statement is there. Okay. That is not a cash book. You have to check. You have to check in the problem, then solve. This is the information related with the cash book. Clear? Now I'll go to debtors and creditors account. Now I'll prepare the debtors and creditors account. Debtors account, creditors account. Simultaneously I open. Okay. This is the debtors account. This is the creditors account. First, you have to enter the opening balance and closing balance of the account. First, you enter the opening balance and closing balance. In the debtors account, two balance brought down. Opening balance is 1,400. Then next you write the closing balance. By balance carried down is 2,000. Opening balance, closing balance. Clear? 2,000. Next, creditors. By balance brought down creditor 2,730. Two balance carried down is 3,000. Clear? I recorded the opening balance and closing balance of the account. Then from the first to the last, from first point to the last point of the problem, you check the transaction related with debtors. Okay. In the receipt side, capital dividend collection from debtors is there. Okay. Debtors collection is there. So it is a cash collection from the debtors, comes in the debtors account credit side. Comes in the debtors account credit side by cash 22,000. Next, cash deal is there, no problem. You go to the payment side. In the payment side, cash paid to creditor is there. Cash paid to creditor comes to the creditor's account, debit side, to cash. To cash amount is 28,200. Clear? Then no other items are there. There is no other items related with the debtor's account. This is the information related with debtors. Okay. So now I collected the First part information is statement of face, cash book, debtors and creditors. If the information is recorded, you close one by one. First, you close the creditors account. Creditors account total debit side is 31,200. Then 31,200 you take in the credit side. What is the difference? Difference is 28,470. 28,470 is the difference. Then what is this? Credit side important items. Credit side important accounts. Opening balance is there. Next important item is by credit purchase. You write as credit purchase. Then close the debtors account. Debtors account total is 24,000 credit side. Then debit side you write 24,000. This is 2,400. It is not 2,400. It is 24,100 is missing. Okay. Then difference you take the difference. Credit sale. Total difference is called as credit sale. This is 22,600. 22,600 plus 1,400 is 24,100 is missing. I am repeating this. Okay. This is the debtors and creditors account. Now I close the cash book. Cash book total debit side is 39,230. And I'll take in the debit side. 39,230. Then the total is tally. Both side total is same. There is no problem. Okay. If there is a difference, you have to give one name to that. If the account tally, then there is no problem to you. Okay. Next, I'll go to statement office. Now I'll close the statement office. Statement office total is 9,230. 9,230 is the asset side total. Debit side total, I write the same. And difference is 6,500. 6,500 is called as capital. 6,500 rupees the capital. Okay. Then the missing information is collected. Now we go to preparation of trading profit and loss account. Okay. Trading profit and loss account. Trading profit and loss account. Come to this trading profit and loss account. This is the trading profit and loss account. First item, opening stock. You take opening stock from the opening statement of affairs already prepared. Opening statement of affairs stock is 4,000. Stock is 2,000. 2,000 is the stock. Then you take the purchase. In the purchase, you have to take cash purchase from the cash book. There is no cash purchase in the payment side, cash book. Therefore, there is only purchase from the creditor account. Credit purchase from the creditor account. Cash purchase from the cash book. You check the cash book if there is any purchase. Purchase a bicycle is there, but you don't take that. Remember, my dear friends. Purchase of bicycle is there for son. And you don't take that account amount to the trading account as a purchase. It is a drawing. You already recorded a drawing. You check, you see the cash book also. Okay. Credit purchase is only there. You take the credit purchase. Cash purchase is not there in the cash book. Then next item is wages. Sorry, cash wages. I'll change it. Wait. Two wages 1,500. Okay. These are the debit side items. Go to credit side. Buy sales. Cash sale is in the cash book. Credit sale is in the debtors account. You take these two items. Credit sale 22,600 from the debtors account. Cash sale 1,200 from the cash book. Total sales is 23,800. Okay. Next item, closing stock. Closing stock you take from the account information, from the problem. 12,000 is the closing stock. Now you close the trading account. Trading account total is 35,800. Credit side total 35,800. Debit side 35,800. Difference 3,830. 3,830 is the difference. This difference is called to gross profit. Then take the gross profit to the next part, that is P&L account part. 3,830. Then you go through the cash book, debtors account, creditors account. You go to the cash book, debtors, creditors. Credit side nominal accounts. Credit side expenses are there in the cash book, debtors and creditors. Record on the debit side of P&L account. If the item or account is in the debit side of the account, takes in the credit side of the P&L account. Serially. In the debit side, there is no item. There is no item or nominal account income on the cash book, debtors account, creditors account. Then if you go to credit side of the cash book, then there are certain items. Wages already recorded. You take the salary. Salary is 800. Next is rent. Rent is 1,200. Then only these two items are there. There is no item in the debtors account. There is no item in the creditors account. Come to the adjustment. Come to the adjustment in the problem. In the problem, first adjustment is depreciation. So you write as depreciation account. To depreciation, under that building 5% 200. Building is 5%. You calculate 5% on the building. It is 200. Then next is furniture 10%. 10% of furniture is 100 rupees. Then you take the total to the depreciation head. 300 rupees. Total depreciation is 300. Clear? Depreciation was over. Next adjustment is provision for doubtful debt. Make provision for doubtful debt at 5% on debtors. So debtors closing balance is, this is 2000. On the 2000, you have to make 5%. So 2RDD, 5%. 5% of closing debtors is 100. Okay, problem is completed. In this way, you have to complete the problem. Trading account, P&L account completed, you take the total. Total is 3,830. Now difference is, difference is net profit. Net profit is 1,430. Net profit is 1,430. Okay. This is the net profit. Any doubt? In this way, you have to follow certain technique to solve the problem. To solve the problem, you have to apply the technique. This is a complicated chapter. I agree with this. But you are a technically one, then everything is easy. You make the complicated problems easy by applying certain techniques. Now we prepare the balance sheet. I'll go to balance sheet. This is the balance sheet of Mr. A as on 31st December 1984. First, you take the capital head. In the capital, opening capital we record. Opening capital is 6,500. This is from the opening statement of affairs. This is from the opening statement of affairs. Then add additional capital. In the additional capital, there are two. One is cash, additional capital invested in the form of cash. Another is private dividend paid into bank. Private dividend paid into bank. These two items are the additional capital. You take the total. Sorry, first I will take net profit. Net profit is 1,430. Next, I will take the sequence. As per sequence, I will complete the process. Just a minute, within 1 minute, I will come. You see this, opening capital is 6,500. Net profit is 1,430. Add this additional capital. Additional capital is 15,200. 15,000 is additional capital plus private dividend paid into bank 200. 15,200. You take the total of these three, total is 22,130. 22,130 is the total. Then from this you deduct drawing. Drawing, there are two. One is drawing, another is purchase of cycle for son. There are two drawing. Total of these two is 3,300. You deduct 3,300, then whatever comes, this is the adjusted capital, adjusted closing capital. Okay, this is the closing capital. Then you take the liability items. That is the creditor. Creditor from the creditor's account, closing balance. Then bills payable from the bills payable account. You take the item. Okay, this is the only one item. Then come to the credit side, asset side of the account. Asset side, first is debtor. You take it in the inner column, 2000. 2000 take in the inner column, less RDD. RDD, 100 rupee. Already taken the PL account. From the PL account, you take this, deduct the 100 rupee, balance is 1900. The next item is cash. Cash, 830. Bank closing 3,400. You take from the cash book or from the balance given in the problem. Next item, stock. You take the closing stock from the trading account, 12,000. Next is plant and machinery, inner column, 4,000. Depreciation on this is 200. You deduct 200, balance is 3,800. Next is furniture, inner column 1,000, less depreciation, 100 rupee. Less depreciation, 100 rupee, balance is 900. Okay, balance is 900. Then you take the total, total is 22,830 is the total. Okay, in this way, you solve the problem. Automatically, problem will tally. If you follow certain method of solving the problem, the problem automatically tally. Okay, without any problem. Thank you. We'll see tomorrow. I'll take one more problem. And my dear friends, remember, I'll solve 10 to 15 problems on this. This is the third or fourth problem. For this year end, I'll take this single entry. And every day, tomorrow onwards, I'll take one problem every day. I'll upload one problem. Okay. And every morning, early in the morning, you go through the Google Drive and study it. Thank you.